For me, I just wanted to do my best. I had a more fulfilling experience in army.
Well, during trainings, a lot of them get very anxious. But after having multiple drills, they are able to overcome this fear.
When I enlisted, I was not fear at all. I couldn't even do like 5 or 10 push-ups. So from that period of time, the progressive training that was applied to us, the different kinds of training that were applied, so that we could gain our confidence. It culminated in, can you make this walk from the top of the island at Dia Tekong all the way down to the bottom of Aberdeen? And I looked at the Singapore man, I was like, there's no way in hell I'm doing this. The me back then and the me now, the me that managed to accomplish everything I could go. Yeah, that's really good training that's happened in the SAF. I like to think I'm doing this so often.
Last time, there's not so much that we call leadership. You come in, you just want to clear the 2 years. It's different from now. NS are trying to develop individually.
Everybody has a story. Don't shut people off just because you're different or because you're afraid of approaching people, and you always have an open mind about every single thing.
It's been a long 2 years, but I'd be lying if I said I wouldn't miss it. From rolling in the mud to firing my first weapon, it has been quite a journey.
My current CSM, second warrant in Ng Xi Tong. I remember during the course, so there's this timing that we have to hit. But you know, all of us being amateurs, you know, we couldn't hit the timing. But he came down, he did it right in our face, and he showed us that it's actually, in fact, it's possible to actually do it. So from there on, he garnered all our spirit, fighting spirit, and from there we managed to achieve the timing. So I would like to thank him for inspiring us during our tough time and our darkest time.
这个是一个路程，就是说每个男孩子就是要为国家争光，要保护国家，就是你要去那边学习，要怎么的去照顾这个国家，就是来帮助所有的新加坡的人呐。
This is National Service is mandatory. It's really what you make of it. There are lots of opportunities in National Service.
Me and my team are on standby 24/7 for whenever a situation arises, be in the form of a terrorist threat or a tip-off provided by a civilian. We have to be ready to act. That's why I can confidently say that each and one of you NSF out there plays a big part in Singapore's defense and security.
Like when you come to the army, actually you learn how to shoot. But when you go outside to the outside world, to the workforce, you want to learn about how, like, what's the responsibility behind that trigger.
A piece of advice to all guys that are going to enlist soon. It's not going to be short. It's not going to be easy. But it's going to be worth it.